Tamika Mallory, my sister, I love you. Thank you for sharing your platform in the name of wellness and feeling good. We love you so much. And so today we're talking about the heart. We've spent the last 3 weeks dealing first from our root, talking about our blood and our bones and, you know, what gives us our foundation. And then we went to the sacral chakra, that area of our reproductive system that deals with our pleasure, our sensuality, our creativity. And last week we talked about the digestive system. That's the place of power. And so our root deals with the I am, the knowing of the self. And the sacral chakra deals with the I feel, you know, the emotions. And the solar plexus deals with the I do, you know, the willpower. And today, we're dealing with the heart. I love. And so as we talked about this journey of relating and relationship to ourselves, the power of the heart chakra is, it's like the balancer. It's right in the middle. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm still partying. Thank you for throwing up the green hearts. I'm going to turn this down because I'm so distracted. I actually just want to get up and dance. So we're going to get into it. So welcome to Feel Good Fridays, everyone. Today we are talking about the heart. And so if you're new to this journey, we're on a journey of self-mastery. We're dealing with our root all the way to our crown and everything in between. Because our goal is to understand why it is that we do the things we do, we eat the things we do, we have the health issues that we do. And in order to do that, we got to go step by step and deal with all the systems. So yes, thank you for throwing up the green hearts. Thank you for bringing friends today. And so like I said, let's just get on this journey. So one of the things that we started with was the I am. You know, we're going to still talk about relationships because this is a hot topic, and I saw a lot of you were texting and DMing. Thank you for texting me in the last couple of weeks to just tell me what's going on with you. A lot of people are dealing with relationship, with self, with others. So we're going to keep taking it to the next level. And so think about this. The root, right? Our blood and our bones, our sexuality, our reproductive organs, and our digestive system. Those are all your physical aspects of self, right? And so most of us operate from our lower self. And most of it we do automatically, or what the body calls autonomically. It's like those systems operate on their own. And they're usually driven by habit, by things we were taught in our environment. So when you ask someone, who are you? They say, I am. And that answer is based on what someone told them, what they were taught as a child, what society told you, or it's their career, right? And so your I am, your root, deals with the fact that even when you identify yourself, it's so familiar that you don't even think about it anymore. And so when you talk about pleasure, if you pick a partner based on what your mama liked, your daddy liked, what you're used to, what society says, you stop thinking about choosing someone that is truly your divine reflection, and you just kind of continue to follow the same habits. Throw your hearts up if you've been in relationships where you find you keep picking the same type of person over and over again, right? And then with the I do, it's about the willpower. It's about the ability to make decisions, to really kind of be discerning before you make that move and not get sucked into the feelings. But typically, we tend to repeat the same habits. And what happens is it sends a signal to what you call the subconscious mind or the back of your mind, which operates automatically, and it makes the brain think that this is how it is. So have you ever had someone say, this is just who I am. That's just the way I am. And that's only because they're so rooted in the root chakra and they're stuck because that's not how they have to be, right? It's just that they may be addicted to the pleasure. And then, of course, they're driven by maybe foods or other sensory experiences. And you can stay stuck in that lower place. Today, we're about to take it up a notch because the heart chakra, the heart, the I love, is actually the balancer between the higher and lower self. So think about it. The heart is the fourth energy center. And so there's the three at the bottom, which is your physicality. We talked about your reptilian brain, your emotional mammalian brain, right? And so that's where most people are driven. Then there's the heart, number four. And then you've got your throat. You've got your pituitary gland and your pineal gland. So you've got three on the top and three on the bottom, and the heart is the balancer at four. No accident, it's the fourth center. The other thing that you should know about the heart is that it is the most powerful organ in the body. Do you know that the heart has more electromagnetic energy and more magnetism than the brain? The heart has about like 60 times more amplitude than the brain. So it is the most powerful electromagnetic organ in the body. And that explains a lot. So your heart represents your ability to have compassion, your ability to really be good with yourself. It allows you to be open and fearless. There's a word that represents this chakra. It's called Anahata. And it just means that, you know, there's no fear. And so when you think about a lion and the lion exudes courage, the courage comes from the fact that there's no fear in the heart, right? There's no pain, there's no fear, and then he's driven by survival from his root. So it's not that the heart is where that energy is. The root is really where the survival instinct then fuels the heart. Does that make sense? Anyway, a little bit of science for you. The heart chakra is located behind the breastbone, and that chakra includes the lungs and it includes the thymus. So the heart, of course, deals with your cardiovascular system. It's the highway for all of your blood, all of your red blood cells, the energy that goes to all the organs in your body. All of the messages and signals are transmuted through the blood, right? The thymus releases glands that deal with your growth hormones and your immune system. The glands for your immune system are here. And then, of course, your lungs deal with your breathing. So why is this important? Because when you have an issue with your heart, have you ever not been able to breathe? Like you get anxious when you find out some bad news or somebody breaks up with you, you feel it right here, and all of a sudden you have trouble breathing because it's in your heart chakra. Or you might find that you have a relationship, and again, it could be with a partner, or it could be with a relative, or it could be a coworker or a child. And somehow that relationship is so toxic that you find yourself getting sick, or you don't have energy, because your thymus is in this area also. And so it releases the glands for your immune system. And so that is why the heart is so powerful. When you are balanced in your heart chakra area, it really means that it's not just about self-confidence, it's about your ability to have compassion for others. See, this lower self was about being selfish, and there's nothing wrong with being selfish. Understand what I'm saying? It's nothing wrong with being about self. Right? But the heart allows you to balance and take some of that energy and give it to others. Does that make sense? And it doesn't have to be a significant other. It could just be people in the community, people in the world. It's just all about balance. When the heart chakra is in balance, usually you'll find that you're irritable, restless, or if you've ever been in a relationship with someone who just doesn't seem to have any feelings, put your hearts up, put your green hearts up. If you know of someone or know of a relationship where or a person who just doesn't seem to have any feelings, they're just cold, right? Or they have no compassion, like someone could be crying their eyes out in front of them and they're just kind of stoic and stone-faced and they don't seem to have any empathy or compassion for the other person. Have you ever experienced that? Well, that's a blockage in the heart chakra. And so some people say, I don't have feelings, I don't get caught up, I don't allow my heart to get involved. To be honest with you, that blockage comes from fear. It's actually not a tough space, because when you're in a space of love, remember in the beginning we said love is an energy and there are only two energies that are always in motion, right? That regulate all human behavior. Well, love is an energy that expands and connects. So when you're in a space of love, you want to connect, you want to expand, you want to express. Fear, the opposite of love, is an energy that contracts and separates. What you talking about? Where you going? Don't talk to me. So when you block your feelings, your heart chakra, it's actually rooted in fear. And that fear comes from pain of the past. So you can calcify your heart chakra area with pain from the past. The other thing you should know is that the hormones that are in the heart chakra area, not only are your growth hormones, but something called oxytocin. And so oxytocin is like the cuddle drug or the bonding drug. Oxytocin is the hormone that's released when you have a baby. And that's what allows a mother to bond with the child. So all you mothers out there, when you gave birth to your baby, the first time they put your baby in your arms, after all of that pain and all of those contractions, you looked at that baby, it was crying, it was filled with all kinds of blood and mucus, and maybe they wiped the nose just good enough so it could cry. But all of a sudden, you felt such a deep love, right? That's the oxytocin. Here's the thing. Oxytocin is also released during sex in women when you have orgasm, or when the sex is really intense or the stroke is really intense and there's a lot of, you know, arousal, okay? So that's why when women have sex with men and the sex is really, really good, even if that partner is not necessarily our ideal mate, we can get hooked. All of a sudden, we're connected, and then we're saying, what are we doing? right? Because we didn't take time to get grounded in the knowing of who we are and understand what could happen if we cross the line and enjoy our pleasure centers with someone who, you know, is cool. I know what it is. They told me what it was. I can handle it, right? But then we, you know, we got it in, and then all of a sudden that oxytocin was released, you know, and you feel it in your chest. Oxytocin is released by the brain, but this chakra is where it processes it. And all of a sudden you feel like, yeah, but I'm in love. There's something about this person I'm so connected to. And that's because that hormone is in your blood. So you really want to have a level of just self-awareness so you know what you're getting yourself into. You know how to regulate yourself, and you want to stay balanced, okay? So on the other extreme, when the heart chakra is blocked or if it's imbalanced, what can happen is that you have no boundaries and you're completely clingy and dependent. And that's also not healthy for obvious reasons. So just kind of throw up your hearts. Let me know what you've dealt with or what you've experienced. A lot of you have texted and told me about situations that you've had, and those obviously stay confidential. Pardon me, my hair is all in my eyes. But it's important that we have real conversations. One of the things Tamika said was that a lot of you want to talk about relationships and talk about what's going on and just understand how to navigate your body within yourself, right? So today we're going to do two things. Obviously, we're going to have a lot of Q&A, so I want to spend time with that. And we're going to announce the winners for the 4 free consultations. But the first thing we want to do is just share a few things that help us get in alignment, alkalize the body, and remind ourselves of who we are when we have issues in our heart chakra area. And so we'll say align, alkaline, remind. I'll say it again. Align, alkaline, remind. One more time. Align, alkaline, remind. You and me, type it in. Align, alkaline, remind. Let's get free. So let's get free of the things that are binding us, that are blocking us, that are causing us to have heartache, right? And that's why it feels like a heartache, because again, the heart is the strongest, most powerful electromagnetic force in the body. Did I also mention that the heart is the first organ that's developed when we become human? Did you know that? In an embryo, while the embryo is still forming and becoming a fetus, one of the first organs that is developed is the heart, and it brings energy to the rest of the body. So that's why the heart is so powerful. If you didn't know that and you learned something new, put your green hearts up. I always love when I can share something that I learned. But also, blockage in the heart area deals with trust. So if you have issues trusting people, if you've been in a situation where maybe you had a bad relationship or you had some challenges and now you're having trouble trusting, that's also something that is a blockage in the heart chakra area. Or you're too trusting, right? Because it's all about balance. It's about being discerning. And when your heart chakra is balanced, it's not so much that you trust everyone, right? You're discerning, but you're also good with being authentic. And there's a difference between being authentic and being like just too honest and telling all your business, you know, because it also leads to imbalance and people can use that against you. So again, blockages come from dealing with pain from the past. And I see my fire is going out a little bit. So if you find that your fire is going out in your relationship, that's also where the heart chakra is blocked. And then you can activate your sacral chakra to really activate that sensual arousal. But I am the flame, I am the fire. If you're feeling me, I'm feeling myself. My heart chakra is open, I feel expansive. I'm so excited to be connecting with you. I'm happy. You know, when you feel good on the inside, it just shows up on your face, doesn't it? At least I hope so. So let's talk about ways that we can get in alignment and help to heal our heart chakra. And again, when I talk about relationships, I'm not just talking about relationships with the significant other. I'm talking about your relationships with yourself. If your heart chakra is imbalanced or blocked, you may find that you just make reckless decisions with your own life. You know, doing things that don't show that you really are in a space of love with yourself. You know, so the first thing that you can do to get in alignment, obviously, green is the color of health and vitality and healing. And so green is an amazing color to wear. I also, I didn't bring my oil with me, but lavender essential oil is really soothing. It actually triggers the olfactory system, your sense of scent. Oh, look at that, I've got some here. And so we're gonna do some deep breathing, but first we're gonna use our tools, if I can open this. So what you wanna do, we wanna do some deep breathing to open our chest, because again, your heart chakra, when it's blocked, when you feel those painful feelings, the first thing you wanna do is be present. You wanna recognize what's happening and you wanna observe it. Like, you know, someone says, hey, you know, it's not working out anymore. I think that we should break up. The first thing you feel is that gut punch. Before you let it go to the throat, stop for a second. Just take a moment. Just stop for a second. And let me tell you why also that happens. Remember when I was saying that the things that we do typically are automatic, right? We get up in the morning, we shower, we brush our teeth a certain way, we take a certain route to go to school or to work or whatever errands we have to run, you know. Even the way we put on our clothing, even the way we wash our body, the next time you're taking a shower, notice where you always start. Do you always start here on your shoulder? If you do, try something different, and there's a reason why. Those habitual things, behaviors, program the brain, right? And so you're constantly in your head, but you're really thinking about the past because you're operating based on what you've done and you don't do anything new. So you can be stuck in your ways. Then you meet someone, your heart opens up, and you're in a space of love. All of a sudden, you want to expand. You feel like you can take on the world. You want to connect with this person, and you feel really good inside. And even if you weren't feeling well physically, you start to feel better. Why is that? That's because when the heart chakra is open, it brings you present. You get out of your head, and you're in your heart. Right? That's why people say it with your chest. When you're in your heart, people can feel when something comes from the heart. People can tell when you're speaking from your heart or you're trying to memorize something from your head. And that's why they say, I'm not feeling you. Right? Or they can tell when you're lying because you've blocked your heart chakra and you're trying to come up with the right excuse for why you didn't get home on time. Right? So you can tell. You may not have known what was going on, but you can tell. That's science. That's science. And so you don't want to be dependent on someone outside of you to be in that space. You want to be expansive. You want to be present, because when you're present, you're aware of what's happening now and you can create something new. This is 2021, y'all. Don't we want to manifest a new life? And so you can be a new being in an old place just by being present. The same people around you that will say, you never gonna change. Oh, you always blah, blah, blah. You know what? Take some time to get still. Let's get ready to do these alignment, alkaline, and reminding exercise, and watch you switch up on folks. Watch your transformation. So the first thing you wanna do is get some aromatherapeutic oil. Lavender essential oil truly calms the nervous system, and it also brings feelings of relaxation. When you're relaxed, your heart chakra is open because you're breathing more deeply. And so you wanna take a little lavender. I put it on my wrist, but you can put it on your palm. By the way, lavender is also really good for the scalp, and I put lavender in my hair. I can't tell you the number of times I walk down the street, not these days in COVID, but when I'm out and about around people that go, oh my God, your hair smells so good. I just take the lavender, I put it on my scalp, I put it in my hair. I usually blend it with the coconut oil, so it has a carrier, and lavender is very good for the hair, so just throwing something out there. But you take the lavender, put it on your palm, rub your palms together really fast, because you want to activate energy. It's like heating up oil, right? And once the oil is hot, cup your hands over your face and breathe in and exhale. And immediately, because of the scent, because it's a natural essential oil, the scent goes up into the olfactory system. It triggers my brain. It releases hormones like serotonin, and it's relaxing and I feel good. So I'm going to show you a breathing exercise that you can do. If you don't have lavender, you are the lavender. Don't ever think that any of these tools, like without them, that you can't do it. I bet you, as a matter of fact, if you think about some green grapes or a juicy green apple or even the lavender flowers. I bet you can smell it in your mind's eye. That's why this is the first eye, the all-seeing. But we're gonna get there in a couple of weeks. Anyway, I also have some crystals. This crystal is rose quartz. Isn't it cute? It's shaped like a pyramid. And so you say, Kepra, that's not green, that's pink. Well, believe it or not, this pink rose quartz for the heart chakra, pink is also a color and so is green. Uh-oh, I hear some HBCUs about to shout out. Yes, pink and green are the colors of the heart chakra. The rose quartz is a really great crystal to use for healing and for soothing the heart, especially if you've gone through a difficult time like a divorce or a breakup or even the loss of a loved one. The rose quartz, the elements in the quartz actually help to activate, stimulate the heart chakra area if you use it properly. And so, you know what we say about crystals, you know, you can clean them off, sit them in the sun so they can activate, burn some sage over it or some Palo Santo, and just kind of bless it with your energy, that's all. And once the crystal is yours, don't give it to anyone else because it comes from the earth and so you want it to give you a charge. Malachite is also a really, really strong. So this is so small. I don't know if you can see, I'm gonna hold it up. This is malachite. Isn't that pretty though? It's like this really odd shape. But look at it, it's raw. It's just gorgeous. So malachite is also a beautiful gemstone and it's good for protecting the heart. And when we talk about protecting the heart, we don't mean closing the heart, but just managing your discernment so that you don't just let any and everybody in. You know, you still have to have balance in that sacred heart chakra space. So I'm gonna take my crystals. I have my lavender. It's all like up in my system. And I'm gonna show you a quick breathing exercise, okay? So what you first wanna do is you wanna do things that are gonna open your chest, okay? So I wanna show you something. Most of us are like sitting like this by default. Check yourself, right? Just by saying that. This is your antenna, your spine. And so you wanna be able to send the right signals throughout the body. You want the blood to flow. And think about your back being a tree. Think about your lungs and how they need to breathe. Right? So you want to sit up straight. And the first thing you're going to do is inhale and lift your shoulders up like that. Now exhale, push the shoulders back. Exhale, push the shoulders down. And exhale, come forward. One more time. Ready? Breathe in. And exhale, exhale, exhale. One more time. Breathe in. And exhale, back. Exhale, down, and stay there. This is good posture. So whenever you want to straighten up, ooh, let me get right, right? And so now my chest is open, I'm expansive, I'm open to receive. And so now I want you to take a breath in and exhale, but I want you to be mindful that your inhale and your exhale are the same speed. And keep in mind, when you are anxious, you have anxiety, you're nervous, you're heartbroken, or you're upset, you breathe like, what's going on? Right? Your breath is shallow, and so are your relationships when you're blocked in that area. So you want to breathe in deeply, and you want your exhale to be as long as your inhale, okay? So open your chest, right? And if you have something fragrant, that's natural. Even, you know, a piece of fruit, you know, you can kind of rub on it and smell it is fine. And if not, again, think of something beautiful or just be fully present. And we're just going to do two deep breaths. Ready? Would it help if I counted for you? I'm going to do four and four, just for those of you who need assistance. Okay? Ready? Inhale. Exhale. One more time, inhale. Exhale. So that was a real short version, but when we go in deeper meditation, when you're by yourself, just be mindful that your inhale is as long as your exhale, okay? And if you can, if you don't have anything green, just think green. Just see the color green in your mind's eye because it is healing, it is renewing. Remember, in the heart chakra, your growth hormones, your body's ability to renew, repair, and regenerate itself. They say that the fountain of youth is also in this area because the hormones designed to repair the body are present there. And also in the heart chakra, the heart is called the seat of the soul. And again, that's because, like I said, this is the strongest magnetic vibrational frequency in your body. So if you want to be more magnetic and more attractive, raise your internal frequency, get your heart light, and you will find that you're more magnetic and people will want to be around you. So the other thing we want to do is get alkaline. Remember, it's all things green. And so you want to eat green foods. You want to, if you have green plants in the house, talk to them, you know, let them give you life because green plants give off oxygen. And then you want to do things like have some green grapes. Don't these look good? Yum. Mmm. Mmm. And enjoy the deliciousness of that. Or eat some green foods. Your green apples, your vitamin C, obviously the immune system, serotonin, that feel-good hormone. Your dark leafy greens like kale are really good for the heart because they help circulation. They have something called vitamin K, which prevents calcium from getting into the bloodstream. Think about this. When you're stressed or you have what you think is a heartache, you send a signal to the brain. The brain goes to the root like, oh, shoot, we got to fight. We got to flee. Your root talks to your gut. Your gut is totally off. And so your instincts tell you that there's a situation. Things are never going to be the same. Because this is happening, my life is over, or whatever the case. And then you begin to poison the blood. You send hormones to the blood because the blood thinks it's got to fight. And so all of those hormones can cause stress. Stress causes inflammation. Inflammation makes the artery really narrow, so it's hard for the blood to go through, and you could feel like you're having a heart attack. Have you ever had an anxiety attack? So you want to be able to regulate your emotions, and your dark leafy greens are totally your friends. Avocados are that good fat. Avocados you also want to have in your diet. Avocados don't really have a taste. So have you ever met anyone who's as bland as an avocado and you're the flavor in the relationship? But anyway, you can put anything on an avocado and make it taste good. Avocado also helps with orgasm because it brings that essential moisture to the genital area for women. I think I said that as properly as I could. And then, of course, kiwi. Your limes you want to drink, put in some warm water. That's good for your lungs, your respiratory system. Remember, you want to keep your lungs open and you want to be able to breathe. If you're a smoker, if you're someone who eats a lot of cheese, if you're someone who has a lot of stress or just congestion, you can also try something called mullein. It's an herb that is really, really good for the respiratory system, especially if you have a dry cough. If you have a dry cough, it's usually because mucus has calcified, you know, in your lungs. It got really hard. So it can actually help to release the dry cough by helping to help the body to release mucus. And it also helps with like chest spasms and tightness in the chest. And what did we say? The heart, the lungs, the thymus. So the thymus releases those hormones that help your body to repair itself. So zinc is excellent for the thymus. Zinc helps to produce, it helps the thymus to produce T cells, and your T cells and your white blood cells are what help fight infection and disease. So I wanted to give you that science because that's important. And most of the time people don't talk about like why we want to eat something. And you know, when you know better, you do better, right? So when you know that a food is going to do something for you, all of a sudden it tastes different. All of a sudden it tastes kind of delicious. This is going to make me juicy. What? Avocados, come here. Apples also. We talked about apples before and how apples are also good for the sexual, for your, they're good for orgasm, okay? Apples are good for moisture in the body and they release a pectin that also helps with stimulation. So there you go. Have an apple a day and an avocado life, if you may. And then of course, you want to remind yourself of who you are. When you're having an experience where you think it's a heartache or you feel that feeling in your chest, what you can do is, again, open your chest or open your arms like this. Like if you're having an anxiety attack or somebody is choking, you have them hold their arms up because it opens the chest, right? You just want to breathe. You want to breathe in slowly and as deeply as possible, and even try holding the breath. Holding the breath slows the heart rate, so your heart's not beating so fast because you're upset, right? So if you're triggered, breathe in deeply, hold the breath, and then exhale for the same amount of beats that you inhaled. So you could inhale for 4, hold the breath for 4, and exhale for 4, and that slows down the heart rate when you hold your breath. And that stops the heart from beating so fast because you want to get control of yourself, right? And then you want to say things like, I am so grateful. Do you know that gratitude helps to heal the heart? When you find gratitude in the heart, in the worst situations or the most painful situations, you begin to shift your mind and the way the mind is processing what's happening. Like, you could have all these hormones going on and it's about to pop off, but you're like, I am so grateful for this experience. I'm so grateful for the growth. I know that I'm growing. I know this too shall pass. I know it's just a moment in time. I am love. I am open to love. I am worthy of love. You know what I mean? And just continue to pour gratitude and speak the word over yourself. Trust and believe your words have power. And so, of course, my night would not be complete without my green drink. And so before we go into questions and announce our contest winners, wherever possible this week, I love the heart chakra. One, because I love drinking greens, I love eating greens, and I love making green, right? So get yourself a money tree if you want, if you believe in that, that's all good. But you definitely want to activate this area because this is a new year, and think about how many people have been going around this year with a blocked heart chakra. This is my chlorophyllion. This is my heart chakra drink. I've got cucumbers for the water. I've got my kale. First of all, I just need you to see something. Look at this kale. Can you see the detail on this leaf? Right? I know, like, you think, like, Kep, you get off on the strangest things. But, like, look at that. This is the lacinato kale, not the curly kale. No, you know, no disrespect to the curly kale. I juice that too, but, like, the lacinato kale has like really nice flavor. Ooh, thank you for all those hearts. So I've got my dark leafy lacinato kale in here for my blood. I've got cucumbers for my water systems, my kidneys. I've got some celery, which is a natural source of iodine. What else do I have in here? Kale. Oh, I've got a green apple. And then I have a little lemon just to kind of balance it out and get my vitamin C. And so here's to you. Oh, this is so good. Sorry if I have a green mustache, but here is to new life. Here is to love. Love is the message for 2021, and I am here for it. And of course, you can tune in every week during Wellness Wednesdays so that I can bring you into the kitchen and teach you another recipe and some additional tools for the heart. But any excuse to take another sip. So green is the new gangster, all right? All week, you want to keep it sexy with greens. You know, greens are going to make you smell good also. You know that greens, the chlorophyll, which is like the blood of plants in greens, is like a natural body deodorizer. So if you find that you don't like the way you smell, the chlorophyll will actually help to regulate your body's sense. And you'll gain a more balanced pH, if you will. So, it was so good, I had to take another sip. So I want to answer some questions, and then after we answer questions, we're going to get to the contest. Oh, yes. Green is the new gangster. Yes, Akia. Peace, queen. I love you so much. Oh, man. Happy New Year. I am so excited to be here. So I want to answer questions, and I might need some help from my team because I... Somebody says super mega greens is life. Oh, absolutely. I am a student of Queen Afua for 20 years. I am a sacred woman. I started my journey in Brooklyn in her shop on Kingston Avenue, and I've been practicing holistic wellness ever since. With balance. I'm all about balance, you know. I like my green juice and I like my red wine, and I'm unapologetic about both because I'm really grounded in the knowing of who I am. And it's all about balance, right? I am not here to turn your life upside down. I'm here to give you tools to help you find balance and what works for you. I'm here to help you recognize what's going on inside of you and figure out a way to self-regulate, okay? So, I love you too. Can aloe go in the drink? Is that the question? Absolutely. Okay, so honestly, I'm going to tell you something. I juiced all my aloe yesterday. Otherwise, I would have been taking a bite in the spirit of the new year, but I was a little greedy. So if you check my Wellness Wednesday on my Instagram page, you'll see that I juiced aloe and pineapple. I washed the aloe, cut off the thorns. I clean the aloe with like apple cider vinegar or lemon juice, and then I cut off the thorns, slice it up, I put it in the juicer, I peel a whole pineapple and I juice the pineapple, and then I take that mixture and dilute it with 50% water and drink it. And it is excellent for the immune system, the respiratory system, reduces inflammation, has 72 vitamins and minerals. Aloe is the truth. Green is the new gangster. So I encourage you for 2021 to do the things that serve you on the inside. The bitters will make you sweet, okay? And we working from the inside out. So someone says, my heart always beats too fast. Should I do the breathing exercise? And I want to say your names. It's going so fast. But yes, you can do the breathing exercises. You want to find time to slow down, to find a place where you can sit still. If you don't have a physical ailment, I want you to think about what is causing your heart to race. Because remember, thoughts are things. And if you've just been operating as a creature of habit the last couple of years, weeks, months, or days, then you're probably not even realizing you may be living in the past. So I want you to take your shoes off. You know, if you notice, I'm always taking off my shoes. And if you have, you know, a floor, a piece of wood, or something natural that you can put your feet on, or even in some water, right? Just get into something natural or nature and just be present to how the water feels on your feet. You know, pick up a stone, a plant, some dirt, a piece of fruit. Just have a tactile experience because you want to be present. You want to be fully present. And just breathe slowly, hold your breath, and then exhale. And that's all you have to do. Just notice how the breath feels cool coming in. And notice that space that where you stop breathing for a second when you breathe in and then you exhale. And just try that. And if you have any other questions, you know you can always text me. My number is 347-273-6933. I always get it wrong. If my team is in here, just could you text my number to everyone, please? I am grateful. You know, it's funny, back in the day, we used to memorize phone numbers and everything is in the phone. And so sometimes I'm a little too high tech and I need to be more high touch. Renee 67214 says, why is it hard to let go of relationships that you know aren't good for you? So Renee, I don't know if you were here when we talked about the sacral chakra, but think about this, right? We've been talking about the lower self, our root, you know, our fight or flight instincts, right? So first you've got your instinct, and then you've got your pleasure center, and then you have your digestive system or your willpower, right? Your instincts, your pleasure center, and your willpower, okay? If you're not grounded and clear in the knowing of who you are, then you're going to automatically go for the pleasure. You're not going to think about if it's good for you. You're just going to immediately gravitate towards something that gives you physical pleasure. And what I just said, if you are intimate with someone and the sex is really, really good, like, and you know when it's good, when the woman's body is very aroused and she gets very wet and the stroke is really deep, and that's why you listen to music and brothers are always talking about their stroke and how they put it down, because they may not understand the science, but they know something happens, and usually they say that's when girls go crazy, right? They start acting crazy. I told them what it was. Now they bugging and now they want to be wifey, right? Because the oxytocin was released. So now, as far as you're concerned, the heart's been stimulated, right? And you're like, what are we doing? Remember last week, y'all, when I was saying we get into these relationships, we get stuck in the pleasure, and then what happens is the next thing, we want to do something about it, or we're forced to do something. So what I would suggest for you, my love, is to do some cleansing and detoxing. Do a little deep breathing, do some journaling, and most importantly, take some time to detox. So that detox could look like, maybe there are some foods. Pay attention to what you're eating. Are you eating a lot of like sugary foods, processed foods, that's your comfort, you know, you're eating to make up for the love? Are you eating a lot of salty, crunchy, you know, hard foods, that's anger repressed, like something that you're holding against yourself? And I also want you to be compassionate with yourself. Like, it's okay if you, you know, decided to indulge. It's now about restoring balance. What I wanna know is, are you willing to do the work? Because while I'm smiling and I play music, you know, it's work, okay? If you want to really heal thyself, you have to do the work. Put your green hearts up if y'all are ready to do the work. It is not, you know, it's not easy, but it's not the end of the world. And on the other side of that is so much clarity and so much joy. I want you to also consider this. That relationship happened for you and not to you. I want you to think about patterns in the relationship, like what attracted you and how many times you may have attracted that same type of individual. You know, it's not the person. They're just showing up to meet you where your subconscious mind is, right? So if you're not present and you're constantly just in habit mode, you're gonna attract the same type of partner. You're gonna release the oxytocin. You're gonna get connected and you'll be in that same cycle. And what that does is start to create these false beliefs like all men are bad, or for men, all women are crazy. And that's not what it is. It's just we wanna break these habits. But I gave you the wrong number, so here it is. It's 347-273-8933. So text me there and let's talk some more, okay? Let me see if I have any other questions for you all. You're so full of love and I love it. And in about 3 minutes, I'm gonna announce the winners for the free consultation. So who said this? Oh, Kitty Boo 70, peace queen. She says, I eat too much cheese. Well, let me tell you, like we talked about before, if you want to have healthy relationships, right, cheese creates mucus. It's just a fact. When you have a cold, the last thing you're craving is, ooh, I want some pizza. You want something acidic like orange juice or lemons. And so cheese creates mucus in the body, and the mucus can come out of your eyes, your nose, your mouth, or your vagina. It's just what it is. So if you want to have a better balance in that area, you want to cut out the cheese or consider some cheese alternatives. And if you text me Kitty Boo 70, I'll give you a couple. Let's see. What else can I answer? And there were a few earlier. It's okay. So who's that? Oh my goodness. This thing moves so fast. Y'all are fast. You type faster than I can scroll. So I tell you what, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna announce the winner, and then if there are any more questions, I'm going to answer a few more. So if you know, was it last week or two weeks ago, in the spirit of the holiday, and today is the last day of Kwanzaa, so today is Imani, which is faith. And I think it's a great way to kick off the new year, the last day of Kwanzaa, because we want to have faith in this year. And faith is related to our belief system. Whatever we believe is the truth to us. It doesn't mean it's true. So think about your habits. Think about how you pretty much operate in the same routine 24/7. You want to just shift those things, right? So that you can have a new life. And you want to start with being present. You want to start with eating foods that are going to give you life. And you want to start speaking the word over yourself in a way that brings you balance and joy. So I'm going to announce 4 winners right now. I think I'm going to ring a bell to shift the energy. So I want you to know how I came up with these finalists. First of all, thank you to everyone. Oh my God, we got so many responses. I was blown away. And so in order to narrow it down, I asked people, what was your greatest challenge or your wellness goal? And so those who responded then became finalists. And I read all of them, so I'm very clear on what I'm signing up for if you get chosen, but I have no idea who's gonna be picked. Everyone's name is typed. And just so you can see, I'm being fully fair so no one can say, oh, she cheated. I'm gonna pick the first person. And so the first person to win a free consultation with me is Vanessa McCullers from Los Angeles, California. So congratulations, Vanessa. I will be reaching out to you for more instructions. The second winner is hold on, I think I need to ring the bell one more time. Each person, each winner gets a heart chakra vibrational moment. Yes. Oh, one fell. Hold on. Okay. The second winner is... Hold on. Janelle Thomas from Sutton Silver Hill, Maryland. Janelle Thomas, congratulations. Okay, I've got two more winners to go. Okay. There we go. The third winner. Oh, I hope it's a brother so we can balance this out. But if not, sisters rule. The third is Janae Grant from Washington, D.C. Congratulations, Janae. And y'all are so sweet saying congratulations. It is so beautiful when your heart chakra is open. You don't have an issue complimenting someone else because obviously if someone is winning, that means they're in your vibrational space, so you're a winner too. So shout out to you. Okay, and the last but not least winner is... Not me for hitting that ball. The last winner is Dorothy Rogers from Phoenix, Arizona. So, as you can see, I mean, when I tell you I was hoping I got somebody from Brooklyn, I'm from Brooklyn. I was looking for somebody from Philly. I got people in Philly. But this is what the universe calls for. So, Janae Grant, Janelle Thomas, Dorothy Rogers, and Vanessa McCullers, congratulations. I look forward to meeting you. Please stay tuned. Someone from my team is going to contact you, and I'm looking forward to the consultation. And, you know, maybe we'll do this again before this cycle is through, just so I can connect with so many of you. Yeah, thank you all for being so kind. I have 7 minutes. Does anyone have another question that they want to ask while we're here? Thank you, Musada. You know, your name is so long, I missed it, but I appreciate your good words. If any of the winners are here tonight, throw your diamonds up. Yep, me first. Yes, Philly's in the house. Yes, Philly's in the house. My Instagram, Brainy Beauty Boss, my Instagram is at Kepra. So it's pinned here, K-H-E-P-E-R-A-H, K-H-E-P-E-R-A-H. And you can also text me at 347-273-8933. When do I begin Wellness Wednesdays? Abba Sunshine. Wellness Wednesdays is every Wednesday on the Life Camp Inc. Facebook page at 6 p.m. Eastern Time. Every Wednesday. Happy New Year to you. I'm Duane. Oh, forgive me. Brown Sugar asks, what do I suggest for kidney back problems? Well, your kidneys are your water filtration system. So you want to definitely drink cranberry juice. You want to eat lots of water. And text me at 347-273-8933 so I can give you a few more wellness tips. I definitely want to stay on the heart chakra tonight. So let's see what else we have here. I just wanted to say to all of you, you know, the heart is also your center of truth. And so if you're feeling any imbalance, you want to take a moment to just sit quietly and really ask the truth about yourself. You know, just sit and feel whatever you're feeling and say, the truth is, and be honest about the truth. And don't beat yourself up, you know? The first part of forgiveness is self-forgiveness. So the first thing you have to do is forgive yourself for even judging yourself for making a bad decision. If you shift the paradigm, every choice, every person who came into your life who you magnetized towards you was designed to show you something about yourself. Remember we said that last week, right? So it's important to remember that. And when you do, you have more control over yourself, and you're no longer a victim in the relationship or because of the relationship. So, Brian Nicole Fletcher, oh my gosh, my pleasure. Tammy Nammy says, when you said that I felt anxiety, what's that from? What did I say that made you feel anxiety? I was explaining something that resonated with you. When I was talking about your feelings, if you felt it, that means that that's something you're experiencing and it's familiar. Anxiety comes from thinking about the past or worrying about the future. Okay, it comes from regrets of the past or pain of the past that we're thinking about, or we're worried about the future. Anxiety comes when you're not in the present, okay? And so think about most of the, that's why I talked about your habits. When you're a creature of habit, you're just programming the brain that this is all there is. So the brain sends more of the same. If you're a person who's constantly irritable or arguing or always getting in little fights, you're programming your brain to think this is normal. And a lot of us are in toxic relationships or, you know, with family members or coworkers that are actually not normal, but because we're so used to it and the brain processes it as normal, we think that it's normal. And then the person goes, this is just who I am. And they're at the lowest level of their self because they're not willing to elevate and grow. Right? Our goal is to take our root and use it to fortify us so we can vibrate higher. Shout out to Layla Dalia for her Vibrate Higher Daily. Oh my gosh. Yes. Listen to your truth. Yes. Yes. And so I want you to be mindful of this mathematical equation. I am or I have. When you say, I just saw someone say, yeah, I have anxiety really bad. Well, you just claimed it and reinforced it. So it's really important, even when you're feeling unsettled, remember, it's just energy in motion. Emotion is just energy in motion. I know it may seem strange, but now if you remember, if the heart produces the greatest amount of electromagnetic energy and magnetism in the body, and energy is always in motion, and there are only two emotions, they are love and fear, then you want to ask yourself, what is it that I'm dealing with? Because fear comes from pain. So it's time to really just deal with the truth. It's like hiding your bills when they come and not calling your creditors. Just open up that space and let's just deal. Let's be willing to face what it is and face our truths. And then forgive ourselves so you can move on. And I know that what I'm saying sounds really simple. These Feel Good Fridays are top line, but I go into a little more detail. I do workshops and webinars. I'll be having one coming up after this series is over so we can do a deeper dive. But I just want to give you something to think about. And information is everywhere. You can look up what I'm saying. You can explore deeper. Or you can call me or text me at 347-273-8933. And we could do a little bit of a deeper dive and I can refer you to some books and information. Okay, so I just wanted to thank everyone for joining me on Feel Good Fridays. Happy New Year to everybody. Tamika Mallory, I love you. Mwah. Happy New Year to you. Wishing everyone prosperity, wishing everyone wholeness, wishing everyone inner peace. Happy Feel Good Friday. I'll see you on Wellness Wednesday. And in the meantime, strong beginnings, no weekends. Strong beginnings, everyone. Love, so much love.